Dear Lord, thank you for this food we're about to receive. May it nourish our bodies so we can think better. Amen.
Amen.
Get your grub on.
You're here at Clary Middle School in the Syracuse City School District. You're working with something called the Promise Zone.
Yes.
Can you tell us like what the Promise Zone is and what it's trying to do here?
Well, basically, there's one of us at every Syracuse City School District, and we're here to support the students in any capacity, whether it be behavioral, academically, or even socially. So we're just here to motivate the kids and make sure they're doing the right thing.
You know, some folks might be surprised you're doing this, but actually it falls right in line with the degree you earned at Syracuse University, right?
Absolutely, Mike. You know, I'm big on education, and I got my degree in childhood family studies at Syracuse University, and I enjoy teaching the youth. They're very important to us. You know, I tell people all the time, the way we treat them is very important.
How big is the program? How many kids do you work with?
Well, right now I'm supporting about 5 to 10 kids that are here at Clary Middle School. But for a whole, you know, I try to make it my business to see every child in this school. We have about, let's say, 300 kids here, maybe 300, 400 kids here. And I try to make it my duty to touch them and see them at least once before the year's over.
When you're working with these kids, do they have any idea who you are and what you were during your basketball playing career at Syracuse?
Yeah. For the most part, they do. Some of them, you know, might have an inkling, or I might get a situation where a child walks up to me and say, Mr. Moten, my father knows you. My father remembers you playing, or my mother remembers you playing at Syracuse. So, they know who I am, and if they don't, I make sure they know. I tell them everything I've accomplished and, you know, what it takes to be a good student athlete and how to try to be successful in this world we live in.
Do you think that helps you, you know, connect with them and reach out to them?
Absolutely. It's definitely important, Mike. You know, as we know, you know, you've been doing reporting for 20-something years now, and I haven't played at Syracuse for 25 years, and it's very important that we learn from the youth also. I tell people that all the time. You can take a little bit of some of the things that they do and some of the things that they know and blend it in your own little way. So I take heed to what they say, you know, and they take heed to what I'm teaching them. So it coincides both ways.
Who were your mentors when you were a young Lawrence Moten growing up in Washington, D.C.?
Well, I love my grandmother dearly. You know, I have a grandmother to this day, 96 years old, just retired 2 years ago, and you know, of course, my grandmother, my grandfather, I had uncles, and my mother, may she rest in peace. But my grandmother, you know, was definitely the focal point in my life where, you know, she told me at the end of the day, you know, it has nothing to do with money. You know, it's all about how you treat people and having a good character. And I try to instill that.
What's the personal payoff for you when you're working with these kids?
The personal payoff for me is just having them understand that I've been through some of the things that they've been through. You know, of course, nobody in this world is perfect. We all make mistakes, and my goal is to try to teach them to do the right thing and how to be respectable people in this world we live in. You know, there's a lot of things going on in this world, and I try to keep it positive. You know, that's one of the main things that, you know, that I try to instill in these kids. And I'm going with, may he rest in peace, the Mamba mentality. And that's being the best you that you can be. Who are your favorite NBA player?
You.
Oh, that's a good one, man. You get a good grade for that.